I'm Mike, and today, how your body transforms over time on a vegan diet. Now, I could just flash some success stories like how Tammy lost 70 pounds in 2 weeks on a vegan diet. Those stories are out there. But instead, I want to be a little more intellectually honest and look at about 8 clinical trials and several other studies on actual vegans, not just sort of plant-based people, and see what happens to your body and when. Now, quick disclaimer, this is not what will happen to you if you go vegan. Everybody is different. Everybody has varying levels of disease and unhealthy diets that they're coming from. And I also want to say that no, if you eat 300 calories a day or 5,000 calories of beer and potato chips on a vegan diet, this also will not happen. Most of the studies in this video are going to be using a diet that is recommended by virtually all of the main plant-based doctors like Esselstyn, Campbell, McDougall, Barnard, Gregor, etc. And I'm sorry, that is not a diet based around processed foods. It's a more balanced vegan diet. All right, let's take a look at what happens on the first couple days of going vegan. If your previous diet included drinking cow's milk, then you will no longer have mammalian hormones manipulating your own hormones. As this study showed, after drinking milk less than the USDA's recommended daily amount, by the way, we see a 25% increase in estrone, which is an estrogen, and about a 20% drop in testosterone. Another thing that will stop is the almost instant animal product inflammation after a meal. Here is a study showing an inflammatory response just 2 hours after eating sausage and egg muffins. So you can kiss that reaction goodbye. And I do want to touch on a fear that people have with the first couple days of a vegan diet, which is understandable with bloggers like this who ate Beyonce's vegan diet for 4 days and all she got was gas. Now, I don't doubt that this is possible. I mean, your fiber intake is going from maybe the 15 gram a day US average all the way up to 30 or more grams a day. And there are studies on an increase in fiber, particularly beans, which will be eaten more on a vegan diet. You may have heard beans, the more you eat, the more you fart, but in reality, it's more like beans, 3% of you might fart more for a couple days, but then life will be better. No, that's not going to become a playground favorite anytime soon. As this study mentioned, with an increase in bean consumption, only a small amount of people, the green bar, notice any increase in gas. And the giant red bar, that's no symptoms at all. And as this other study mentioned, those symptoms were shown to fade at about 48 hours anyway. You can then go on to reap a lifetime of benefits from legumes, which, as this study mentioned, were the one food most associated with survival in elderly populations across the world. And it's important to note that this first week on a vegan diet, this isn't just your stomach getting used to vegan food. This is a shift in enterotype, a shift to a vegan gut biome, which means less flesh-eating, potentially pathogenic bacteria, and more protective species, as this study mentions. Specifically, from a more Bacteroides-dominated enterotype, Bacteroides feeds on animal proteins and fats, like what we are made out of, which might be why it's more associated with colon cancer. Shifting to a Prevotella-dominated enterotype, which feeds on plant material and is more protective. Here's one that demonstrates this vegan gut shift. Those on a vegan diet had higher levels of short-chain fatty acids like propionate and butyrate, which are highly protective, and those who didn't adhere to a vegan diet had higher levels of trimethylamine oxide. As the study mentions, eggs, beef, pork, and fish are major sources of carnitine and choline, which are converted by the gut microbiota to trimethylamine, then oxidized in the liver and released into circulation as trimethylamine oxide, which is linked to atherosclerosis and cardiovascular disorders. Now, getting to 7 days in, I think it's fair to say that most people's digestive systems will have adapted by this point, and I want to address the myth that you will poop 7 times a day, as some bloggers have said. As this massive Oxford study found, yes, this was studied, vegans only poop about 7% more than vegetarians and are 3 times more likely to be regular than omnivores. All right, moving right along to week 3, we are reaching our first clinical trial, which demonstrates putting a group of people on a vegan diet and then measuring the changes. Dr. Esselstyn's trial of about 200 people going on a vegan diet with cardiovascular disease demonstrated clearing of arteries at this point. Here is a before shot of blood flow shown in red using a radioactive tracer showing largely blocked blood flow in one of the patients, and here is much higher blood flow in the same patient 3 weeks later. Essentially normal blood flow. All right, moving on to week 4. This is where you die of a protein deficiency. not! Actually, vegans were shown to have higher levels of blood protein than omnivores, which was statistically significant and possibly linked to their lower inflammation. All right, now we're gonna fast forward a few weeks. All the while, changes are happening, but we're gonna look at a few clinical trials that measured those changes at the end, starting with one at 12 weeks. This randomized control trial showed that if you have diabetes, it is possible to have your blood sugar lower by 28%. This one at 14 weeks showed that if you are obese, you could see a 13-pound weight loss, a 3% body fat loss, better gluten tolerance, and insulin sensitivity. At 16 weeks, this study put people who had migraines on a vegan diet, and 88% of them showed improvement in their headache pain, and the number of people that needed medication for their headaches lowered by one-third, and let's not forget the potentially life-saving 22-point drop in total cholesterol. And now another trial, this time on office workers, which is especially relevant because they're normal people not selecting for disease. They found that they had an 8.5-pound weight loss and their blood work improved across the board. Now to 22 weeks out with a larger diabetes trial, 43% of these type 2 diabetics were able to lower their diabetes medication. And again, we saw about a 30% lowering of blood sugar levels, as well as a massive lowering in LDL or bad cholesterol, and a 13-pound weight loss and a couple inches off their waist gone. And now another 22-week trial, another office worker trial, again looking at normal people. Of the statistically significant findings, they found that, quote, "The vegan group reported improvements in general health, physical functioning, mental health, vitality, and overall diet satisfaction compared with the control group." Counter to the myth, quote, "The vegan group also reported a decrease in food cost, though to be fair, increased difficulty finding foods when eating out." But most impressive of all, the vegan group reported a 40 to 46% decrease in health-related productivity impairments at work. That was based off how many days of work they missed for health-related impairments and how much time at work they missed for them as well. And that means that no matter what you're trying to do in your life, a vegan diet can help you get that done without having a health-related impairment. Perfect example. I, in all the times on my YouTube channel, have never had a sniffly nose or missed making a video due to some flu or cold, and I probably just jinxed myself, but it's true. And a quick reminder, all of these studies will be linked in the description below if you want to take a closer look at these numbers. All right, moving on to 6 months, even a low-carb vegan diet will lose you 12 pounds and lower your LDL or bad cholesterol by 18 points. So you can eat a variety of vegan diets and still see these benefits. Okay, let's look a little bit further down the line to one of the longest vegan trial follow-ups, back to Dr. Esselstyn's cardiovascular disease study. After 12 years, those who stuck with their vegan diet only had a 0.6 chance of having heart attack or stroke, and those who fell off the wagon had a 60% chance, 100 times more heart attack and stroke. Now, once you get past the length of dietary trials and are officially a long-term vegan, then you can glean some insights from population studies. And with that, I want to mention a point that you really can't expect all of the results that you've seen earlier in this video while still eating a lot of processed foods. But if you take your previous omnivorous or vegetarian diet and eat the same proportion of processed foods that you did then in your vegan diet, you will still see benefits. And I say that statement based off these population studies on vegans who eat a standard vegan diet and still see massive benefits, like 63% lower incidence of hypertension or high blood pressure, 62% less diabetes overall, 16% less cancer, 15% lower mortality, 10% less heart disease, a normal BMI average, 10% less hypothyroidism, and more. But if you want to go all the way to ditching processed foods, I do have a video on a whole food vegan transition, and I will link it below with a lot of other better resources for doing that. In conclusion, though it's really impossible to know exactly what changes will happen and when for you, we can gauge from the clinical trials in other studies that you will most likely lose weight if you are overweight, lower your blood sugar if you have diabetes, clear out your arteries if they are clogged, lower your cholesterol, have a better, healthier microbiome, increase your productivity and mental health, and ditch those hormones that manipulate you in dairy products and those inflammatory animal products altogether. And last but not least, a clearer conscience because you are not eating those cute, cuddly animals, which you love. I know you love them. All right, that's it for today, but I do want to quickly mention that this was a request video as one of you was trying to go vegan and needed a little bit more motivation, so feel free to request what you want to hear me talk about. All right, thank you for watching, and feel free to subscribe if you don't want to miss the next one.